Welcome to this episode of Adam Answers. For this episode, I am going to read a question from somebody who posted a comment on Facebook. And the username there was The Underachiever, which I think is kind of a unique, awesome name. But The Underachiever writes this question, and it says, one of the challenges when it comes to SFBT is when you want to make sure that the client's preferred future is something healthy, logical, and doable. So the challenge I've found myself in is when the client believes their preferred future is healthy, while in reality it isn't. Or it's logical, while it's not. Or doable, while it's not. And to move them toward thinking a bit more critically about their preferred future, I thought it would be best to invite them to think about it a bit more fairly, or go forward into the preferred future for them to find that it's not really healthy, doable, or logical. But I wanted to ask about what we can, even when those things may fail to enlighten the situation. So, underachiever, I really appreciate this question, and it's kind of a nuanced question. I'm first going to start with the idea of things not being logical, things not being healthy, things not being doable. I think one of the things by making that statement is that there's a level of assessment on our behalf as SFBT clinicians. And one of the things that I would say is that assessment isn't necessarily our job. Our job is simply to get a desired outcome and to get a description of that desired outcome. And so I think I would be cautious about assessing, is something logical? Is it doable? Is it healthy? Because I don't know what the client's situation is. I don't know what their circumstances are. And therefore, I don't know what actually might be doable or not doable. I don't know what resources they have that they might be able to draw on. And so I think one of the things I would say is be really, really careful about making assessments in that way. Now, however, if somebody says, like, I want to fly to the top of the mountain, right? In our heads, we might think, okay, that's not a doable thing. Humans don't have wings, those kinds of things. Now, one of the things that can really, really help is simply to ask, and if you were able to fly to the top of that mountain, what difference would that make to you? Or what impact would that have? Or what would you then be able to achieve? And by asking these follow-up questions, what we're doing is we're getting to an actual desired outcome. We are getting to a place where they would say, well, if I could fly to the top of that mountain, maybe I would have freedom, or I would be able to feel happy. I would have this sense of independence. Now, those are things that we can talk about. We can talk about freedom. We can talk about independence. We can talk about happiness. And so sometimes an initial answer might seem illogical or undoable, but it's not really our job to assess that. It's our job to say their answer is a completely appropriate answer given who I'm talking to. But it's our job to turn that into a conversation that we are capable of having. Oftentimes these kinds of like creative or imaginative things will come up when you're working with children, and they may not have the words to kind of put into it. They might say, like, I want to be a fluffy unicorn. And again, we might think, oh, that's impossible. But what they're really saying is, like, I just want to have fun. I want to be able to do whatever I want. I want to feel like I have magic. And again, those are things that we can get at. So embedded in here is like, well, what are the qualities of a good desired outcome? And I would say typically it tends to fall within two criteria. One of those criteria is what we often refer to as an internal state. It's something inside of a person. It's usually a feeling or an emotion or a state that is encompassing what they want. And a second criteria is that it's a transformation. It's moving from what they don't have to what they will have. And again, this is a transformation about the person, not about their world, not about their circumstances. And so one of the things that's important about it is if it meets these two criteria, it helps us kind of mark, okay, this is a kind of conversation that I can have. And so if somebody says, I want to fly to the top of the mountain, that might be a transformation, not being able to fly, but it doesn't meet that criteria of an internal state. It's an external behavior. And so changing that, hearing that answer will make me think, okay, how do I turn this answer into an internal state that also meets the criteria of being a transformation? So holding those two criteria helps me to know, oh, it's not time to move on yet, because I haven't really gotten to a place where we have a desired outcome that's usable or something that I can formulate a conversation around. Now, you also kind of mentioned in your comment of like, could we move forward into the preferred future with this desired outcome and see if they can kind of get to a place where they're logic through and be like, oh, well, this actually isn't doable or logical or whatever. And I would say we don't even really have to move forward into the preferred future if we get a desired outcome that meets those two criteria. So we might think of these kinds of things that are illogical or not doable as reasons why we need to continue to clarify. Another example that comes to my mind is one where Elliot was meeting with a young kid, and he said, when he said, what is your desired outcome? He said, I want to be a rapper, I want to be a football player, and I want to get my mom out of the place where she lives. And again, I might think, okay, that's impossible. You can't be a rapper and a football player. Those two careers would take all of your time and energy. You wouldn't have time to do both. Getting your mom out of there, you're a teenager. How could you possibly do that? So I might, if I stepped into that role of an assessor, I might say, these desired outcomes are impossible. But if I take those desired outcomes and I say, let's get to a place of an internal state, let's get to a place of transformation, I then just take him very seriously and I say, and if you were able to become a rapper, if you were able to become a football player, if you were able to get your mom out of the place where she currently lives, what difference would that make to you? Then he would say things like, I would feel happy, or I would feel excited. I would feel like I was doing my duty. Now we're getting closer to internal states. Now we're getting closer to transformations. And then Elliot did something that's really, really beautiful, is he said, now let's suppose that you have those kinds of things. You have happiness, excitement, whatever. And those things are going to lead you to becoming a rapper, becoming a football player, getting your mom out of the place. So he held on to that language and he used it. And he said, all these things that you're going to achieve, they'll lead you in that direction. What's the very first thing that would let you know you're now on the road to doing those things, not that you have achieved those things? And I think that's a really subtle nuance of there's a slight shift that happens, and now you've taken the first step onto that road of the slight difference, which will lead you way in a different direction. And so the preferred future that we jump to isn't suppose you're a rapper, suppose you're a football player, none of those like really far down the road things. It's suppose happiness enters into your life that's going to lead to those things, and today's just the day where you've taken the first step in that direction. It makes it something that's now really relevant to the current situation. And the other thing that it does is that it lets us move in that direction without having the definitive endpoint as those things. Because just moving toward being a rapper or just moving toward being a football player may help that kid get better grades or work really hard, be dedicated. And those skills, those characteristics that he develops along the way to becoming those things, those might change his mind about where he wants to end up or what he wants to do. And so it's not that we have to get to the end of a road that feels illogical, because they might change as they pursue that. They might realize, oh, what I actually want is this thing over here. And so I think, again, it's not my place to assess, is it the right thing or is it a logical thing? Is it a healthy thing? But what it is my job to do is to have a conversation that is a conversation that is about a real desired outcome, where I can get to an internal state and where I can get to a transformation. And that kind of a conversation will help to kind of moderate how far down a particular road I need to go. So I hope that was helpful. Please let me know what your thoughts are. I would love to hear what your reaction is to this. But I hope that provided a little bit of clarity.